Okay, so let's get started with this reaction equilibrium problem. This has to do with CO2 hydrogenation. Given the actual final equilibrium fractional conversion of carbon dioxide for a fixed feed at a fixed temperature, we're asked to determine what the pressure must be at this final condition. We know what the reactants and products are here, and they're fairly common ones, and they're all in the vapor phase. We can compute things like a delta G of reaction. If I label my components 1, 2, 3, and 4 for CO2, hydrogen, methanol, and water, just for simplicity, then I can write a delta G expression as follows, where I have the delta G of the products minus delta G of the reactants. And then we can look these up in any standard textbook, for example. And we plug in the numbers from the back of the textbook, and these are all in kilojoules per mole. And then we just sum those up to get about 3.5 kilojoules per mole as the delta G of reaction. And then very similarly, we can write out the same sort of expression for delta H of reaction at 298 Kelvin. And we get that the delta H of reaction is negative 49.3 kilojoules per mole. And so this is an exothermic reaction. And so since it's exothermic, we can actually go ahead and answer part B. And so point B asks, well, if while conducting the reaction at higher temperatures, but fixed pressure, increase the equilibrium yield? And the answer is no, that as you increase the temperature, because heat was a product of an exothermic reaction, and then raising the temperature will lower the equilibrium yield in this reaction. So you'll form fewer products. It's a hallmark of an exothermic reaction. All right, so now returning to part A, if we have delta G of reaction as 3.5 kilojoules per mole, then we can determine the equilibrium constant. And that's just equal to the exponential of negative delta G over RT. So in that case, that will be equal to 0.241. Yeah, so now we want to be able to relate this equilibrium constant to an extent of reaction. And so to do that, we'll establish a basis of 1 mole initially in our container. Right? And we know that the number of moles of CO2 is initially equal to 0.15 moles. And then we will be converting 13% of that 0.15 moles according to the problem statement. So what we have left is 0.131 moles. All right. Similarly, the number of moles of hydrogen, we start with 0.85 moles. We can convert 3 times the amount of moles of CO2 that we convert, according to our balance equation. So we know we convert, this is how many CO2 moles we convert. And so 3 times that number of moles is shown on the line below. And that means if we add this up, we have 0.792 moles of hydrogen left at the end. And then in terms of the number of moles of water that we formed, it's equal to 0.15 moles times the 13% conversion. And that's how much we reacted away of CO2, and that's also how much water we've formed according to the one-to-one stoichiometry. And so this is equal to 0.0195 moles of water. And we form just as much methanol as we do water. And so that is also equal to 0.0195 moles. We can sum up all those to determine how many moles we have at the end. And so that gives us a total number of moles of 0.962. Right now, what we need to do is express the moles, or convert the moles to mole fractions for each component. And so in order to do that, we just need to compute a Y of CO2, for example. Is just equal to 0.131 moles over 0.962 moles total. And so the mole fraction,
once we've reached equilibrium,
is then 0.136. And similarly, we can do this for our other components. Okay, and so now we can take these mole fractions. We have these available. And if we want, we can determine the value of our Ky, our mole fraction equilibrium constant. And that will be equal to the mole fractions of the products over the mole fraction of CO2 times the mole fraction of hydrogen to the third power. And if we just plug in all the values for Y, 0.0054 for the mole fraction equilibrium constant. So now to finish this up, we need to just relate the equilibrium constant to the pressure. And so to do that, we recall that the equilibrium constant for a gas phase reaction is equal to the K of the mole fractions times the pressure to the sum of the stoichiometric coefficients of products minus reactants. And so we have two in this reaction. We have a total of 2 moles of product, so 1 mole of methanol, 1 mole of water. And we have a total of 4 moles of reactants. So 2 minus 4 is -2. And so this means that this is equal to Ky times the pressure to the -2nd power. We solve for the pressure. That's equal to Ky over K, both of which we've already solved for, taken to the square root. And we can just plug in those values. And if you solve for this, it's a pressure of 0.15. And recall that the units on pressure are the units at which the standard Gibbs free energy and enthalpies of formation are reported. Right, so we have to be thermodynamically consistent with those. And recall that the values are chosen such that the ideal gas assumption is a good one. And that makes things more convenient in terms of the derivation of the equilibrium constant. And so in this case, for our textbook, these are reported in units of bar, but it could equivalently be atmospheres, just depending on where the values are reported. So 0.15 bar is the final pressure in our system.